All right, Valentine's Day is just around the corner. Are you ready? Here's a tip for you guys out there. If you really want to impress your lady, cook for her. You know, she probably does the cooking all the time, and it's nice to have a guy do it for us. You know, yeah, you can take her out to a fancy restaurant, but that's what most people do anyway. So be different and impress your lady. Now, in my house, if I had no offerblats to the cooking, it would be TV dinners. Not very impressive. So for those of you who really want to do it upright, I have the perfect recipe for you. It's called cutlets. Don't ask me how to spell it because I have no idea. I got this recipe actually from my first husband's family. The dad of that family was in the Navy, and if I remember the story correctly, this was a recipe that they picked up when they were stationed in Italy. Don't know if that's true, doesn't matter. It's an absolutely delicious recipe that I still love to this day. All right, you need four things. You need frozen breaded veal cutlets. You need shredded mozzarella cheese. You need some deli ham or luncheon meat ham. And you need a little bit of oil because you're gonna fry the veal cutlets, okay? This is how easy it is to make and fast. I personally use an electric skillet to do the frying. It's up to you. You can use a frying pan if you don't have an electric skillet. Now you'll notice I'm actually making four patties. The serving size is just one per person, but these reheat pretty well, so I use the other two for lunches during the week. So anyway, and for oil, I personally use peanut oil. It's up to you what kind of oil you want to use, but you just need enough in the pan to fry. This is not a deep fried dish, so you just basically cover the bottom of your pan. Follow the instructions on your manufacturer's package. I've used a lot of different brands of veal cutlets over the years, but it's always been somewhere between 4 to 6 minutes per side. Basically, you want to get them golden brown, and that's it. You're almost done at this stage. Now, you take them out of the pan, and you're going to transfer them to some kind of broiler pan or roaster pan. I personally do this next step in my toaster oven because it's just easier. If you don't have a toaster oven, you can use the broiler in your main oven. But ideally, you have a pan like this. You'll notice that there's ridges and little holes. That helps any excess oil from the frying process drip away from the dish. If yours doesn't have that, you might want to take a minute and pat your fried patties with paper towels to get rid of any excess oil. Now, after I've got them all laid out on the pan, here comes the mozzarella cheese. I cover the tops with mozzarella cheese. Then I lay down the ham. Now the slices of ham are bigger than the cutlets, so I fold them in half. Put that on top of the mozzarella cheese on each patty, and then more mozzarella cheese. Now me personally, when I do four patties, I go through an 8-ounce package of shredded mozzarella cheese, give you an idea how much I need. So anyway, you see I've covered them in mozzarella. Now you just have to pop them in the toaster oven long enough to melt the cheese. Remember, that's all you're doing. So in your broiler or toaster oven, just long enough to melt the cheese. It's that easy. I mean, it's a very, very quick, simple, easy recipe, guys. You can do this. Now, personally, when I serve this dinner, I make rice pilaf and green beans, but you guys may not want to go to that much trouble. So here's all you have to do. When you're at the grocery store getting your cutlets and your cheese and your ham, stop off in the produce department and get those bags of salad fixings. They're already cut up, shredded up, everything ready to go. Just pour some of that into a couple of bowls, add some nice big chunky croutons and some nice salad dressing, and you're good to go. It doesn't get any easier. Just don't let her in the kitchen while you're fixing this, or else she'll know just how easy it really was. All right, there you have it. A simple, easy dish that will impress your lady, and it really does taste good. I love this dish. Let me know how it turns out, guys. Hope you have a wonderful Valentine's Day. That's all for this week. Come back and see me.
See ya.